Another free update for Apple's Final Cut Pro has been released. This video is about the, in my opinion, really amazing new voice isolation that has been added to 10.6.2, which some may actually already know from iOS. How this works and what there is to consider, let's take a look right now. Robin here from Post Professionals, and before we get into the nitty-gritty, a quick heads up. For the voice isolation option to show up in your inspector, you will of course need at least Final Cut Pro version 10.6.2, but also a minimum of macOS Monterey version 12.3. So if you're not seeing it, then you're simply missing one of those two updates. Okay, so the voice isolation in Final Cut Pro works by prioritizing any detectable human voices over other parts of the audio signal, and that using AI, or rather, machine learning. In other words, the tone or pitch of anyone's voice is basically irrelevant. So the better the human voice can be recognized, the better the voice isolation itself will, of course, work. But in the end, there are always limitations to everything. Someone recorded with an iPhone or built-in camera microphone most likely won't wield nearly as good of a result as when recording with a lavalier or shotgun mic, for example. And while isolation is in the name, that's not its sole purpose. Because I've already seen many extreme examples, and while that is an actual possibility, I really see it as a voice improvement filter first and foremost. So for more unforeseen difficulties in my audio that I would like to improve with minimal effort but maximum results. Also, as with any audio or video manipulation, as we'll see, a healthy degree of restraint is always recommended. There are no magic bullets, and less can quickly become more. Okay, so let's take a look. So where do I find it and how do I use it? Well, in usual Apple fashion, it's both super easy to find and super easy to use. And yes, I too have a couple of intentionally extreme cases here just to show how far one can push the isolation. But to start off, I want to show a medium-sized problem with a clip that someone recently asked me how they could best get rid of the background noise and maybe even the wind noises you hear every once in a while. Let's take a quick listen.
Liebe Schützenschwestern, liebe Schützenbrüder, liebe Würdenträger, lieber Schwemanzow, liebe Harthauser Musik und liebe Gäste, ich grüße euch ganz herzlich zu unserem Jubiläumsschützenfest 2019 und lade euch ein zum Kommerz heute Abend ins Festzelt.
Okay, I would actually say this is a fairly classic real-world situation, a spontaneous outdoor shoot where there was little time or opportunity to set up for decent audio, let alone somehow turn off the wind. We have some high-frequency white noise, but even more so some constant low-frequency rumbling because of the wind, with some occasional very prominent gusts that I've marked with some markers. So while the speaker is still fairly well audible, there is a good amount of room for improvement. And if you have the opportunity to make it that much better without actually making it worse, why not do it? And that's in fact something I can now do with the new voice isolation. But first, just in contrast, something I think probably most of us have attempted in the past with varying success is to use the noise removal filter that has been in Final Cut since day one. If I apply it at the default 50%, you can immediately see the change in the clip's waveform, and it even changes as you adjust the slider. But I'll leave it at 50%, and let's take a listen.
Liebe Schützenschwestern, liebe Schützenbrüder, liebe Würdenträger, lieber Schwemanzow, liebe Harthauser Musik und liebe Gäste, ich grüße euch ganz herzlich zu unserem Jubiläumsschützenfest 2019.
We can hear that at least the low-frequency rumbling sound and a good portion of the white noise has been noticeably reduced. But if I thought to myself that any amount of wind noise is unacceptable, I could of course simply try to set the noise removal to 100%. Listening again.
Liebe Würdenträger, lieber Schwemanzow, liebe Harthauser Musik und liebe Gäste, ich grüße euch ganz herzlich zu unserem Jubiläumsschützenfest 2019.
I can hear that almost all the low-frequency rumbling has been filtered out, but the gusts of wind are still clearly audible. On top of that, as I'm sure many have experienced themselves, are the noticeable tinny artifacts here and there that make it sound like a not-so-great MP3 file. So let's see what the new voice isolation can do for us in comparison. I'll first deactivate noise removal and simply go to the top of my audio enhancements and activate the voice isolation. This too has a default setting of 50%. If I play back the clip once again.
Liebe Schützenschwestern, liebe Schützenbrüder, liebe Würdenträger, lieber Spielmannszug, liebe Harthauser Musik und liebe Gäste, ich grüße euch ganz herzlich zu unserem Jubiläumsschützenfest 2019.
I would say the results are even noticeably better than that of 100% noise removal, especially when it comes to the low-frequency rumbling. So at this point, one just would need to decide whether a little bit of residual rumbling and a couple of gusts are okay or not. If you decided that you didn't want to hear anything from the wind, you could simply put playback on loop by hitting Command L, assuming it's not already active, and while it's playing back, adjust the percentage of the voice isolation and hear the results in real time.
Euch ganz herzlich zu unserem Jubiläumsschützenfest 2019 und lade euch ein zum Kommerz heute Abend ins Festzelt. Liebe Schützenschwestern, liebe Schützenbrüder, liebe Würdenträger, lieber Spielmannszug, liebe Harthauser Musik und liebe Gäste, ich grüße euch ganz herzlich zu unserem Jubiläumsschützenfest 2019.
Pretty amazing. So if I was okay with maybe a couple of gust noises, then something around 90% could already be perfect for me. But if I in fact wanted the wind noise removed entirely, I could simply set the voice isolation to the full 100%. And if we listen now...
Liebe Würdenträger, lieber Spielmannszug, liebe Harthauser Musik und liebe Gäste, ich grüße euch ganz herzlich zu unserem Jubiläumsschützenfest 2019 und lade euch ein zum Kommerz heute Abend.
I think one could agree that they are pretty much completely gone, which I find to be quite impressive. But as with so many things, a maximum setting, of course, also goes at the expense of overall quality and some artifacts in the more difficult areas. For example, when he turns his head away from the camera. And I'd probably have to compensate a bit in terms of volume as well. But to be honest, I don't actually think it's all that bad. For personal use, I'd say it's definitely more than acceptable. A paying client may prefer the 80 to 90% range. And maybe just one other example, which is intentionally almost nonsensically extreme. Unfortunately, since it was spontaneous and I was using a lav mic, I kind of forgot to watch my gain while recording, so it's rather distorted here and there. But I couldn't re-record it for, I think, obvious reasons. So let's just ignore that for now and play it back.
Yeah, so who hasn't had this happen? You know, you've out on a long day of vlogging and you just want to get back to the chopper and the pilot starts the engine way too early. Where is he? Oh, he's back there. So now you got all this noise and your shot's ruined, right? What are you gonna do? Well, you get voice isolation.
Okay, clearly an extreme but not entirely unrealistic example. You're recording someone, and unlike in this case, some unexpected noise is in the background. But as in this case, re-recording is not an option, and the otherwise ruined take, of course, will end up being the best, right? But usually, the shot as is isn't really imaginable. So let's see if we can turn this into not an optimal, but at least more usable option. Again, we're unfortunately not going to get the distortion removed with voice isolation, but how much of the background noise do you think it'll take care of? I think you'll be very surprised, because I know I was. I'll simply activate the voice isolation and start with the default setting of 50%. I'll select the clip with X and hit the slash key to play the selection and just hit it whenever I want to restart from the beginning. The marker showing the more or less loudest point of the helicopter engine. Let's take a quick listen.
Yeah, so who hasn't had this happen? You know, you've out on a long day of logging and you just want to get back to the chopper, and the pilot starts the engine way too early. Where is he? Oh, he's back there. So now you got all this noise and your shot's ruined, right? What are you going to do? Well, you get voice isolation. Yeah, so who hasn't had...
Okay, already at 50%, it sounds much better, and I really don't feel that the actual voice frequencies have been compromised to an unacceptable degree. If I continue to play it in a loop, and again adjust the strength of the voice isolation with the slider in real time as I play back...
Yeah, so who hasn't had this happen? You know, you've out on a long day of logging, and you just want to get back to the chopper, and the pilot starts the engine way too early. Where is he? Oh, he's back there. So now you got all this noise, and your shot's ruined, right? What are you going to do? Well, you get voice isolation.
I'd say it sounds amazingly good, again aside from the distortion. At least to the point that it is exponentially more useful than the original, and the isolation is clearly trying to maintain the full frequency range of the voice when audible. Just for fun, let's take this to 100% as well and take a listen.
Where is he? Oh, he's back there. So now you got all this noise, and your shot's ruined, right? What are you going to do? Well, you get voice isolation.
Okay, going too far makes the voice sound more nasal and underwater, but amazingly, the helicopter is nearly removed completely. Turning it on and off during playback...
Where is he? Oh, he's back there. So now you got all this noise, and your shot's ruined, right? What are you going to do? Well, you get voice isolation.
Just shows what an amazing job it's doing. I don't know about you, but that blows me away, and I really have no idea how in the world I could get that result with any amount of fiddling, assuming that's even possible.
Pretty amazing, isn't it? Nobody can tell me that they don't already know where they're going to use it first. Anyway, it's once again a pretty cool update, in my opinion. But I'd also like to know what you think of it, and if there's anything you'd like to see changed or improved. Feel free to drop us a line down in the comments. And don't forget that there are also some very nice improvements to the recently added motion tracker, which I'll be covering in a separate video soon with a special download. If I haven't already by the time you watch this one. If you're in the mood for more tips, tricks, and tutorials, or if this video helped you, give us a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel so as not to miss future content. And if you can't decide on anything, maybe check out one of these videos YouTube thinks you'd like to see. In the meantime, thanks so much for watching, and I'd love to see you back in the next video. Take care of yourselves and stay healthy.